Okay, everybody, Steve Greene here, and today I'm going to tell you how to get monster triceps, courtesy of Harry Pearl, who is Bill Pearl's brother. I trained at Bill Pearl's gym through the 1970s, and Harry Pearl was there too. Harry was bigger than Bill, and I actually trained with Bill for several years, and I never trained directly with Harry, but Harry would give all us young guys tips, and he had an exercise that he liked and claimed it was how he got his big triceps, and he had huge triceps. And we just came to call him Harry's, H-A-R-R-Y-S, named after Harry Pearl, the guy that showed them to us, okay? So now, whether or not these are strict textbook perfect, according to somebody's model of how you should do triceps, that's irrelevant. I'm gonna show you what Harry showed us, all right? And I'm going to show you first with a barbell, an easy curl bar, with the hand grip shoulder width or narrower. And then I'm going to show you with dumbbells, you can do the same thing. All right, so these are Harry's. Harry's, they're basically three different moves that are done in one set. Okay, and what it does is it, as the tricep fatigues on the positive movement, part of the movement, then you go to the second part, which is a negative movement because you're stronger on the negatives, letting it down. And then you go to the third part, which involves heavily the pectorals, but it keeps pumping those triceps. And if you do this if you take this to the max, you'll really work your triceps. And don't go by me as far as, you know, building monster triceps, okay? I'm not a monster anymore because I'm 71 years old, and I don't take any testosterone supplementation at all. No TRT, nothing. I take nothing, all right? I just eat a vegan diet, and that's all I do. So I'm going to show you what Harry showed us, and it worked for Harry, and it worked for all the guys that tried it, all right? So first, I'm going to show you with an easy curl barbell. All right. So basically, it's like a skull crusher or a nose breaker or a jaw breaker or wherever you want to bring them to, okay? So you let it down like that, and you just keep doing these literally until you cannot get it up again, okay? And so let's say I'm at a point to where I come down and I can't get it up, okay? Well, you don't stop the exercise there. Here's part two of Harry's. You bring it to your chest, nipple level, and you press it straight up, and then you let it down in a negative fashion. And then you bring it to your chest, straight up, and let it down like this. And the reason for this second part is because it works the triceps in the resistance part, letting it down, the negative. What I call negatives, what we all call negatives back in those days. And you keep doing that because you can, after you fail on positives, pushing the weight away from the earth, you can still keep doing the negatives, letting it down because your muscles are stronger, okay? So then you get to the point, let's say where you let it down to there and you're almost out of control, okay? And you know to do another one of the second part is too dangerous. And you bring it to your chest, and then you finish up with basically a real close grip chest press, like this. Okay, and if you do each portion of this three-part exercise to the absolute maximum, and you're not shortchanging yourself, by the time you get to this point, you'll reach a point to where you can't even press it up like that, and your triceps will be fried. And of course, I'm talking between these. You wouldn't wait. Basically, you're doing your positives like this. You can't do another one. You immediately come into this and start doing the negatives. And when you let the negatives down, you let them down slowly. Okay? And then when you can't do any more negatives under control without hurting yourself, then you go in to this third part. All right? And those three parts equal one set. All right, now that's how Harry Pearl, Bill Pearl's brother, showed us to do these things. And we all loved them. We all loved them. And now I'm going to show you how to do it with dumbbells, which I think are actually better because you can get a better stretch and you'll feel them more in the inner head. Okay, so let me get the dumbbells. Okay, so now you have your dumbbells. You let them down. See how much farther you can come down. I like dumbbell work because you could come back. If I couldn't come down this far with a barbell because my head is in the way. So you do as many of these as you can. And let's say that's the last one. You struggle to get it up. Then you come down slowly, and then you bring it to the chest, okay? Slowly, this is part two now, bring it to the chest. Slowly on the negative, see how far you can come down? And then you bring it to the chest. And the nice thing about these is, when you fail on the negative, you're not going to break your nose or crack your skull because the weights are coming down here, okay? Now, when you can't do any more negatives under control, then you bring it to the chest and you keep your elbows narrow and you do this kind of thing. All right. That is the third section of the Harry's. And just doing them for this demonstration, I can feel it in my triceps really well. Now, I like the dumbbell because I do get more of a stretch. Instead of just coming down to here, you know, I don't know, it's probably not that much. You can feel it either way. But those are what we at Pearl's Gym in the 70s, all the guys that were doing them, we were calling them Harry's. Let's do a set of Harry's, okay? And we loved them because by the time you get done doing a set of Harry's, and if you do like three sets of them in a row, and let's say you're working out with two other guys, I do a set of Harry's, the second guy does a set of Harry's, the third guy does a set of Harry's, and then I go again, and then the second guy, and the third guy, then I go for the last time, and then the second guy, and the third guy. So I've done three sets of Harry's. And believe me, your triceps are absolutely, totally pumped, and you feel like a million bucks. And you walk out of there, it just feels like you have big, I don't know, you know, it feels like your arms are massive, okay? And if you're not an old dude like me at 71, then you probably are going to have like really big arms. So give the Harry's a try. They were invented by Harry Pearl, brother of Bill Pearl, in the 1970s. Big brother Harry, you know, he wasn't in contests and wasn't all famous like his younger brother Bill, who was multiple Mr. Universe winner. But he knew what he was doing. The guy was a giant. And we always listened to him. And Harry was the nicest guy. He was as nice as the day is long. He'd help you with exercises. You know, it was just great. He was very helpful. And I don't know if he's around still. I hope he is. You know, Bill Pearl's 91 right now. And Harry was a little older. I don't know if I can find him on the internet, but I might try to see if he's still around because I sure liked him too. He was real nice. All right, give Harry's a try. And see how they work for your triceps. See ya.